Hello students, today we are going to start with the next chapter of computer, that is computer devices. In this chapter, we will learn what are computer devices and what are they used for. So let's get started. First, what do you mean by input devices? Input devices are the devices or the parts of a computer that are used to enter data into a computer. Input and output devices together are known as computer peripherals. So come, let's learn some of the commonly used input devices. So the most commonly used input device is keyboard. It lets a user enter data and instruction into a computer. A standard keyboard has 104 keys. Now coming to the next input device, that is mouse. What do you mean by mouse? It is also known as pointing device. It controls the movement of the pointer on the monitor. It has two buttons, left and right, and a scroll wheel in the middle of them. A computer mouse can be divided into two types. First one, ball mouse, which uses a ball for the movement of the mouse pointer. The ball is present under it. The second type of computer mouse is optical mouse, which uses an LED light for the movement of mouse pointer. The third device that is used for input into our computer is scanner. A scanner reads the text or pictures printed on a sheet and transfer it to a computer. For example, a printer or handwritten document, photograph, or so on can be transferred into a computer using a scanner. The flatbed scanner is the most commonly used scanner. Now coming to the next input device, we have microphone. It is used to record an input voice, sound, and music into a computer. Now coming to the next topic of computer devices, we have the second category, processing devices. The CPU is the only processing device in a computer. CPU stands for Central Processing Unit. CPU is also known as the brain of a computer. It controls the input and output devices attached to a computer. It processes the given input and provides the accurate output accordingly. The CPU is made up of three parts. The first part is memory unit. It stores all the data and instruction temporarily or permanently. The second part of CPU is control unit. This controls the functioning of all the parts of a computer. This unit does not process or store data. The third part of CPU is arithmetic and logic unit. This unit does all the arithmetic calculations like addition, multiplication, subtraction, and division. It can perform logical operations also, such as less than, greater than, or equal to. Now coming to the third category of computer devices, we have output devices. What do you mean by output devices? Output devices are the one that give the result after processing the input. So output devices basically show the information or data into our computer. So coming to the first type of output device, it is monitor. So what does a monitor do? A monitor looks like a television. It is also known as VDU, which stands for Visual Display Unit. It displays the output produced by the computer after processing the input. It can show both text and pictures. The output displayed by the monitor is called soft copy. Now coming to the next types of monitor. So there are basically two common types of monitor. First is CRT monitor. These are the oldest among the three types of monitors. So basically we are having the CRT monitor, which are bigger in size and takes more space. It consumes more power and it is bulky in size. The next type of monitor we are having, LED. These monitors are also light in weight and it consumes less power. It is thinner and takes less space. And the third category of monitor can be LCD. But here we are studying only two common types of monitor according to our syllabus, that is CRT and LED monitors. Now coming to the next device of output devices, we have printer. So what does a printer gives? It gives the output onto a sheet of paper. The printed output is called hard copy. The most commonly used printers are dot matrix printer, inkjet printer, and laser printer. Next output device we are having is speakers. Speakers are used to play music and sound stored in a computer. So a computer system may have inbuilt speaker or otherwise external speaker can be connected through wires. Next device is our headphones. They let the user listen to any sound from the computer without disturbing others. So headphones are small speakers that can be worn in or around your ears. The next category we are having, storage devices. A computer can store a large amount of data. All the data and information is saved in its hard disk. Apart from hard disk, we are having CD, DVD, pen drive, and so on to store data permanently. These are called computer storage devices. So coming to the first type of storage device, we are having hard disk. The hard disk is an inbuilt storage device in which data is stored by default. It looks like a small box which is fixed inside the CPU cabinet. The next storage devices we are having, CD and DVD. CDs and DVDs are used to store a lot of information. You can transfer data from one computer to another using these devices. So CD stands for compact disc and DVD stands for digital versatile disc. A DVD can store more data than a CD. Next device of storage we are having, pen drive. A pen drive is very small in size, but it can store a huge amount of data. It can also transfer data from one computer to another, like CDs and DVDs. A pen drive is also known as flash drive. A USB can also be used to connect various peripherals to a computer. USB stands for Universal Serial Bus. So hope that you all will be clear about what are input devices, output devices, processing devices, and storage devices. Thank you, students.